Hello, everyone. My name is Sophie. I would like to start with a confession. As a learning system designer for many years, I have been believed learning system could be designed by logic, data, dashboards, methodology. I built products and platforms. I refined algorithm. I adjust the difficulty levels until one message changed everything. A woman, she left one of our learning system, and then she left one message. It is very short and unforgettable. She asked, "You never ask me why I want to start learn at the first place." It reminds me something very interesting. It is about, actually, sometimes invitation, it is better and it is much more important than the instructions. Because when we are trying to build the personalized journey for her, we are trying to give her the very interesting content. We are trying to measure what is the kind of methodology she really likes. However, her subconscious is not really looking for this kind of badge, but is looking for a permission. This kind of permission is trying to make her feel very curious about something. It's making her feel like she would like to try, and also make sure she feel like exciting about the learning system. It belongs to her, but not everyone else. Several psychologists, Desi and Ren, so they gave us a very interesting insight about these things. Actually, the motivation from our insight, like about ourselves and also about the meaning, it is much more important than the external motivation, such as badges and also other things. The true learning experience, it is start not from the direction, but from a desire. And after talking about the desire, I would like to talk about the next thing about learning, guidance. Let me ask you a question here. Have you ever followed the GPS confidently? So if yes, you can like here raise your hands up. Yes, it looks like I am not alone. In the year 2018, I was driving to one of my friends' home. I'm trying to follow Apple Maps. So the Apple Maps told me, turn right, so I turn right. After turn right, suddenly I stopped because I feel like, okay, my car stopped. I'm kind of like get stuck in the train track. The glass smashed and the flame lit up the darkness. I was thinking, had I died? I died because I followed the guidance too much. If you are thinking there is a tombstone of Sophie and Messi, here lies Sophie. She might believe technology and guidance too much. Think about this. So this is the thing. Sometimes when we have outside sources, we kind of trust it too much. This is the world now we are living right now. Now, a lot of things is kind of like flooded. We have a lot of intelligence guidance in our world. We are trying to follow the GPS. Sometimes we follow the applications, AIs. But the question is that, will this kind of like technology or are this guidance is really trusty? This is the question I want to leave here. What if this kind of guidance could lead to a very, very bad direction? That is the thing that I think it's very important we can think outside of the box. And then I would like to share another story. This story is about chicken. When I was 2 years old, I was born in a very beautiful small village in China. One day, my mom purchased several chickens and she came. She would like to teach me how to count. And every day she asked me, Sophie, how many chickens we have? First day I said 9. And the second day I said 21, because you know the chickens, they are moving around. And there is one moment I probably say, oh, we only have 7 chickens. Why I realized that? Because I found, okay, for my father, this moment he is in the yard. Next moment he is like in the outside of the kitchen. But I still only have one father. So this reminds me like my father is kind of like a mobile chicken, but it's the thing, like kind of like my first course in my life, like in 2 years old, it is about reality and perception. And this is very interesting thing I would like to share. In our brain, actually we have two systems. So one is more about intuitive and another one, it is about logic. When we are learning something, sometimes there are several like chemical things is changing in our mind. Sometimes a beautiful physical connection is happening in our mind. So we can really leave the time for our brain. It is very important. So pause before making the decisions, especially when we feel like something is kind of weird. That is our subconscious brain trying to give us some signal about what is the real world. And another thing about perspective and also about reality, it is when I'm trying to give 100 people one photos and I get very different answer. Maybe we can check here. So here is the art. This is art, it's from the year 1632. I'm going to give you 10 seconds. You can think about what you can find from this art. If you are doing something related to the history, maybe you can see the history period. But if you are like some designer in the trend, maybe you can spot the trend. And also, if you are doing something about the art, maybe you can see what kind of brush they are using there. And also, if you are doing something about research or about relationship, you might think, okay, what's the relationship between these two people? So sometimes we think we are realize the reality. However, a lot of our data like filtered. We are not just seeing with our eyes, but we are seeing everything with our histories. So this is another awareness I would like to say. It is awareness like before assumption. That is very important. And our data size like incomplete. We can think about like that. So we got a lot of things, a lot of data, and then we uploaded into the system. How those data really reflect the reflection? Are they biased or they are the real natural data? Another thing is that when we are observing the world, sometimes we are using our conscious brain, sometimes we are using our unconscious brain. And then we can really find the difference between the people. Majority, over 80% is from our experience. That is the sea, and also that is the data we can see like in the world. A lot of application and the guidance based on incomplete data, and we can think about that, whether this kind of thing is really reliable or no. How about the thing go to another direction? If we can collect the data from everything. Several months, I went to Norway. I met one artist. What he's trying to do is that he's trying to paint all his data set in his own life in a very beautiful building. The building looks like a church. So what he's trying to do is that he's putting a lot of things like his relationship, his childhood, and the messages, a lot of things in this building. However, so this guy kind of confirmed the answer for us. It is never could be complex. When he's doing the learning thing, he gets something from the real world and then he connected something with his own world. He feels like the creation, it is much more interesting than the efficiency. So every time when we create, we add a new line to the unfinished story of the human knowledge. That is a beautiful part of the learning. So this is the five things like from the five stories. So the first one we are talking about is permission before the performance. And second one, question before compliance. And pause before certainty. And awareness before assumption. So the creation before efficiency. We have been living in the old formula of the learning for many years. It is much more talking about the content, completion, and compliance. Today, I'm trying to give a new formula for the learning from the brain, behind the brain. New formula is related to curiosity. It is related to outside of the guidance. It is related to the time. It's related to awareness. And also, it is related to the creation. Today, I'm still designing the learning system. But when I'm designing the learning system, I'm not only focused on the performance, not only about the tasks, but I'm thinking, what is the best way we can unlock the black box for everyone? How we could like collect the natural data from every person to make a better personalized learning platform? At the same time, we can collect every pulse, every emotional signal, and everything from a person to make this learning platform more insightful. So in the last, I would like to say, so every street, the lies, and all the truth is crude, and time itself is a circle. And about the learning, learning was never meant to be a straight line. It loops, it bends, and it spirals back. When we are doing learning, it is not about downloading something from the human's resource, but at the same time, we are uploading a lot of very beautiful moments of our own knowledge spots. This is me, and welcome to connect me after this event. Thank you so much.